planned up to this point, but one day it could be put aside because Grand Lodge's plan is going to go into action. Okay? And then you're going to see him given to you, into your lives, an abundance of everything. Because you have paid a price. Other people have paid a price on both sides of the family to see you guys come to this point. Then to see anything less than the power of God will be taken away from what you're intended to be. And I'm honored. Man, I just want to be a part of it. I just want to see the power and the wisdom of God come into you both in the name of Jesus. And I said something last night that was silly. I'm sorry, I apologize about it. In front of this congregation, I said something about Fallon graduating from Baylor. You didn't? That's all I'm going to say. But the wisdom of God will come to you, my young friend, my young wonderful grandson. The wisdom of God is going to come to you, and you're going to have strength to carry out your task as a man of God to give her exactly what she needs for her life. Do you hear me? This is Paul Paul speaking. Okay, do you guys need to join right hands? Or you can join both of them, whatever. As a representative of Jesus Christ before Almighty God, in the name of the Father and of the Son, and by the power of the Holy Spirit of God, I now pronounce you one together. You are now husband and wife. Not here. I tell you, okay? Will you turn this way to the Lord, me? And I want to speak a blessing. Well, this is supposed to be a joyous occasion. I'm doing my best. I want to bless you through the Word of God, because I can bless you, and I'm going to with a prayer, and everybody's going to join you. But for this blessing, this is from the Word of God. And it carries power that I can't give you. Only God can. 1 Peter chapter 3 says, a man and his wife are heirs together of the grace of life. I'm going to read to you your blessing, your inheritance. So listen carefully. According to Deuteronomy chapter 28, all of these blessings will come upon you and will overtake you. Not just come upon you, but will overtake you if, there's that word, if you will hearken unto the voice of the Lord your God. Blessed shall you be in the city. Now, this is not going to make much sense to a lot of people, but it will make sense to you as you hear it. Blessed shall you be in the city, and blessed shall you be in the country. Blessed shall be the offspring of your body, and the produce of your ground, and the offspring of your livestock, the increase of your herd, and the young of your flock. Blessed shall be your basket and your kneading bowl. Blessed shall you be when you come in, and blessed shall you be when you go out. The Lord will cause your enemies who rise up against you to be defeated. Okay? You get me? Any enemy that comes against you is going to get a hedge. I'm going to pray a hedge about you. They will be defeated before you. They shall not come out against you one way, and they shall flee before you in seven ways. The Lord will command the blessings upon you in your barns and all that you put your hands to. And he will bless you in the land which the Lord your God will give you, now gives you. The Lord will establish you as a holy people to himself, as he swore to you, if you keep the commandments of the Lord your God and walk in his ways. He's talking to Israel here. But you are part of Israel. We are Israel too, because we are sons and daughters of the Most High God. And you are too. So all these blessings are going to come upon you. Now before I allow you to kiss your bride, I'm going to say a prayer of dedication over you, and I'll let everybody out in the wedding party to kind of gather around them and just lay hands upon them. And we want to speak a blessing. And when you have open hands, that means you receive. You receive from God. But when your hands are turned over, it means you don't receive. So I want your hands to be open to receive not only financial help, spiritual help, every kind of help that you're going to need is going to come because you have open hands to believe and to receive in the name of Jesus. Okay? Let us bow in prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray a prayer of dedication of Mr. and Mrs. Landry Lee. Lord, these two people were ordained to be together by you in heaven. I can sense that right now in the name of Jesus. They were ordained to be married. They're ordained to be people of God that will represent you not only in churches, but in the marketplace or wherever they go, wherever they work, wherever they make a living. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus that you will give them increase of everything that they have need of. Father, it will start today in the name of Jesus. And Father, I speak the blessing of God to come upon them from the top of their heads to the soles of their feet. They're feeling an empowering of the power of the Holy Spirit to carry them through life, through the tough times, through whatever times they come through. Lord, may they always know that you are with them, and they have a lot of people in this place that are going to be standing with them and praying for them in the name of Jesus. And Father, thank you for these young people on either side of them, the young ladies and the young men who are laying hands upon them and believe it as well, that you have begun a great work in them, and the Lord, you're going to complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. So, Lord, we submit them to you. We dedicate them to you. We lay them on the altar of sacrifice, that you are a living sacrifice, and these two people are alive and well, and, Lord, you can use them in the kingdom of God. Father, open up doors that no man can shut, and shut doors that they don't need to go through. But, Lord, I pray that their life is ordained with you and will be an instrument of love, acceptance, forgiveness, and hope to a lot of people. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Y'all get out of the way.
Amen.
There's going to be a kiss in the middle of that. I have one requirement. I've never asked you.